looking at a show, and you have to, you know, there's so many different kinds of choices you can make, you know, comedies, dramas, all different kinds of things. We've done Les Miserables before. We did it back in 2004. So it really wasn't necessarily on a list of shows we're looking at. But because the movie came out, it was hugely popular.
I love the movie. I went on Christmas Day with my whole family. I was really looking forward to it, and I was just blown away by it. And I was like, God, I wish we had a musical this summer, because I feel like we'd have the perfect cast to do Les Mis.
You could see when they announced that we were doing Les Mis, I like jumped up on my seat and like did like an arm flappy motion. And I didn't believe Mr. Everest when he said it, because my brother and I, who was also in the musical, we talked for so long about how much we wanted him to do Les Mis, and so I didn't believe him when he said that we were actually doing it.
But when he announced that, just like the fact that we were having a musical was awesome, because we'd been bothering them about that forever and they never knew anything, and the day they told us, we were so excited. It was awesome.
Yeah, so and if it's that, trust me, being stupid is fun. You have license to be stupid on the stage. I give that license to you.
Yes. I'm no longer a child, and I yearn for the truth that you know.
Otherwise, you'd be here for like 5 minutes.
So what do you play? Sorry.
I'm just in the chorus. I have a few solo parts.
What are the solo parts? How you start off the show?
I start off the show, you know? Open it up.
Yeah. So basically, how good the show is on you.
Based on me.
Is that a lot of pressure?
I can handle it.
Good.
How's it going, Ben?
It's going good.
Yeah. So what are you doing right now?
I'm getting into my Master of the House costume.
Oh, yeah? Mm-hmm. How many scene changes do you have?
Costume changes,
yeah.
That costumes are probably like 5 changes.
Okay.
I'd bet.
Yeah. That's pretty good. Pretty good. How about you, Gavroche? Getting pumped?
Yeah.
Yeah, thanks.
Uh-huh. Gotta keep the throat.
What's your pre show ritual? What do you usually do?
Cough syrup and cough drops, because I have a really bad cold right now.
I heard so if you drink olive oil, it really like gives your vocal cords, yeah.
Yeah, I'm sure.
And if you eat sandpaper, that's also really good.
Yeah.
When you look at a show, you want to have a show like Les Mis, you have to have incredible depth of talent. It's not a show where you have 2 or 3 leads and that's just it. You know, a lot of shows you have male and a female, and the whole show is about them. They fall in love, they break up, they get back together, happy ending, it's all exciting. But Les Mis, you have to have a huge depth of parts, and we knew we had a lot of depth of talent this year at the high school.
And I mean, coming in day one, we all were really excited about the musical. We had all seen the movie, we all knew what was going on, so we all knew what it was gonna take to pull it off.
Pretty much from day one, I felt like the energy was pretty high from everyone in the cast, including principals and chorus.
You usually have a great opening read, you know, when you have that first read through of everything, and it's exciting, it's the first time everything's fresh, so everybody's excited.
Towards the beginning of June is when it started to drag. We had those late, like 4 or 5 hour practices that went until midnight or something, or set building.
We've got finals, we've got our concerts, we've got state contests, we've got everything else that we're dealing with, all the recording sessions for the CD and all that stuff.
But I feel like as more practices went on, everyone was seeing it come together, everyone was seeing all the characters start to work more fluidly with each other, and it just turned out to be a great show once we got everything together, and I think that is why the energy was so high.
It's that last week where you really kind of discover, because of the pressure of the show, it makes you not just work harder, but go deeper inside. And I think people pull more out of themselves, and they're more honest with what they're doing on stage, instead of just trying to act on stage and sing on stage and do what they think they're supposed to do for us on stage. They're bringing aspects of themselves out that they didn't even know about themselves. And that discovery is really what makes everything brand new and exciting when we get to the actual show.
The dirt beneath my feet.
come in, sir, for you are weary. And the night is cold out there.
Now take a pan, my little mademoiselle, and go and draw some water from the well.
Who am I? Who am I?
You're Jean Valjean.
A typical person at work, they say it's a 40-hour week, and I think it's way more than that for us. By the time we finish the day with the cast, we're still working on sets in the afternoon.
There was about a week there where I was getting, no, about 2 weeks, so I was getting about 2 hours, 3 hours sleep a night. And it's overwhelming. But, you know, we had great people to work with Mrs. Everest and Mrs. Bowski and Mrs. Rummel and Mr. Slavin and Miss Graff, everybody, all the people that were working with us, because there's so much to do in a show this size.
So, thank you for that insight. Okay.
You're very welcome.
But if you just hook the foot there and then just, you don't need to bring the hands all the way up like crucifixion, just bring them up here. Like about here, as long as we get that, because then we'll get that silhouette up against it, okay? So let's come try it again. As best you can, bend back at that waist. Don't bring your center of gravity past your hips, gotcha. And you'll be okay.
World that cannot hold, I'll escape now from that.
Watch your feet a little bit, there you go.
From the world of Jean Valjean, there is nowhere I can turn. There is no way to go.
Never gets easier. Never gets easier.
I think, like, a big lesson I took from it is just to keep fighting. Because there's so many times in that story that Jean Valjean could have just given in. And he just keeps fighting for what he knows is right. And same with a revolution. Like, they know they're probably going to die, but just because of what they believe strong enough that they're going to fight to the death for it.
My favorite line in the musical is the one Angel Ross says, which is, it's time for us all to decide who we are. And I really like that one because, you know, we're going to be graduating soon and some of us have already graduated. And I just think that's a really good line because it's the truth. We have to start figuring out life. And that was definitely my favorite line, I think. And I thought about that a lot during the musical.
It is time for us all to decide who we are. That's absolutely my favorite line in the whole show. And I think about it often. Because whether you're on stage or off stage, or you're in high school or you're not in high school, you're going to college, you're just starting, you have to decide who you are. And I think it's so important that people are who they are all the time.
Well, I'm not a person that really follows like the lovey-dovey like love story stuff, so. But the overall message is to love another person is to see the face of God. And I completely agree with that. No matter what someone puts their heart into, as long as they put love and stuff into it, it's going to be successful even if you end up dying in the end, which we all do. But I think that's the main thing that I connected to with the story is if you truly love something, it doesn't matter how it ends. It's the journey to get there is the most important part.
I think in choir we have a family every year, but this choir this year was just closer than most. When you only get those two performances, they would do anything to have one more performance. But it wasn't just that. I think because this year we've had a journey with the film being made and everything else that I don't think people really ever thought it was going to end. After tour, I've got the last concert. And after the last concert, I know I've got when the movie's going to premiere, and I know I've got the summer musical. And then you got to the summer musical, and I don't think people were prepared for there to not be One Day More. So One Day More in the show really is people asking for One Day More when they know there isn't going to be One Day More. When those students are at the barricade, they're expecting people to rally to them, and they're expecting that there's going to be a victory, but I think deep inside they know it's not going to happen. I mean, that happens in the song when they sing Drink With Me. They know that after today, One Day More is not going to exist. One Day More means I have one day more, and then after that, there won't be One Day More. And I think that's what a lot of people in the cast finally realized when the time of the show was all done, is that I I want one day more. I'd do anything to have one day more. And then you got there and realized all along, just like the people on the show, that there isn't going to be one day more.
There was a time when men were kind, when their voices were soft, and their words inviting. There was a time when love was blind, and the world was a song, and the song was exciting. There was a time. Then it all went wrong.
What a lot of people don't understand is that we have this once-in-a-lifetime opportunity to put on this show, to do it full-blown Broadway-sized, and it's one of those opportunities that we'll never get again.
It was one of my favorite things I did in high school, the two musicals. It's just something that not everyone gets a chance to do. Be on a stage that big, with the full pit orchestra and the lights and everything, just, it's pretty much a professional show, just we're not getting paid for it. And it's just taught me a lot of lessons about work ethic and stuff like that, just to know that I have to know my stuff to be on stage with a show like that.
What always impresses me is that I don't believe they're high school people on stage. It's so professionally done, and it's so professionally played to the audience that I, even as the director, have bought into the characters.
This is the perfect kind of show for students to do because it's all about what high school students face every single day. All of the things that they have to learn about, what is it like to choose my path in life? And what happens if something gets in the way? Will I be able to rise to the challenge like happens with Valjean and Javert? Which is what happens with high school students all the time. I think I've got everything figured out. I got all my stuff together. I'm ready to go. And then something comes along, you realize, man, I have no idea what's going on.
It's nice because even though it's a lot of complex and hard things, people underestimate teenagers and like the depth that they have with like understanding inner turmoils and like hardships and stuff, especially because a lot of the characters are pretty young. Jean Valjean goes to prison when he's pretty young, and Fantine's really young when she dies.
There's a grief that can't be spoken.
Well, I didn't cry, but it was pretty rough. It was kind of like the last choir concert, like this is going to be my last time on stage with a lot of these people. And I still think there's no better feeling in the world than coming out for the curtain call after a show. And just a whole rush of emotions came over me, like happy, sad, that was my last show. And it was just a whirlwind of emotions that night.
When I see that opening curtain, I'm just thrilled to get started because I want other people to see it. And I love hearing the audience reaction to people and watching the faces of those on stage that I've known for such a long time.
Oh, it's exhilarating. I mean, everybody talks about how before you get on stage, you're just terrified, but you can hear them laughing and crying and applauding and reacting to everything. So you just get really, really excited. So by the time you're actually on stage, you have so much adrenaline in your body that all you can think about is, let me try to add on to what people before me have already done.
Probably about a couple minutes before the show started on that Saturday show, which was our last show, I was overwhelmed with just, it was like excitement for the last show, sadness because it was the last show, but then it was just like a overall determination to make that show the best one possible for the cast, for me, and for everyone that came to the show.
But I think what makes this group so awesome is that everybody does it together. And so you can stand back and say, I painted that, or I built that, or we built it together, and know that you can stand on it and it's not gonna fall apart. and that when it comes to that opening night of the show, or even closing night of the show, you know that you made it together.
So when we do stuff like the musical, and this is my first one, I realize how we all come together, and that the lines between mixed choir, varsity choir, concert choir, those lines are completely destroyed, and we're just the Mohawks. We are the group of people putting on this performance. There are no lines, there are no, oh, he's a freshman, oh, she's a sophomore, you know. It's all we are together, we're in this together, we're doing this performance, that's all that matters.
The friendship that you have during the musical is unreal. You just can't describe it. You meet so many new people and you just share so many memories with people, and the bonds that I already had with people just got so much tighter, and it's just a gift that you're so lucky to have, to be so close with each other.
It's a magical feeling, it really is, and saying that sounds super corny and stuff like that, but it's true. I've never felt closer to like the choir until doing the musical. I realize how much it means to everybody and how it can really bring out the best in people. The fact that we might not be able to do it again makes this current moment, this current musical, even more special. The thought that this could be the last one. And so people really step up their A game to make this one the best one.
I was really happy to see that it worked out to where we could have our musical, and it does mean a lot to me. Means a lot to the seniors. I think it means a lot to the faculty too, for Joel and Miss Bowski to work with us one last time before we head off as kind of our going away present, as I like to think of it. But I think it means a lot to our school and everyone a part of it, just to have that last hurrah.
Well, I feel like if there's not the musical, then a lot of kids won't get the opportunity to do something like that, and that could spur a lot of interest in kids, and not only just make them want to be actors, but like there's so much stuff we have to do with building the set, doing lights, that kids can get interested in and maybe take a career in that, and it gives the kids the opportunity to explore at a young age.
If you can't really explain it, but you know what it was, everybody that I think that was in that show, when they sit down and they talk to their parents and they try to explain where they went, and they would try to list what it meant to them for their friendships with each other, what it meant to them for what they learned about themselves, what it learned about the skills and everything they learned, but what it meant because of what it felt like. And I don't think they could sit down with their parents and explain that. It's not a conversation you could have. Not because it's not something you don't want to talk about, but because it's something that's so personal and so deep and something that you really just can't even totally understand yourself. And that's the most valuable experience of all.
Do you hear the people sing, singing the song of angry men? It is the music of a people who will not be slaves again. When the beating of your heart echoes the beating of the drums, there is a life about to start when tomorrow comes.